Euglenoids. So in the euglenoids, they having that, so at that anterior side it is invaginate, so generally it is grown in that fresh water and stagnant, so it is a fresh water and it is a stagnant water. Stagnant means what is the meaning? Stable water. It is having that two flagella, so it is a one is large flagella, long flagella, another one is a short flagella. But so when both are comes outside, it is appear just like one, but having that two flagellas, one is long, another one is short. Okay, so they are generally, they are grown in the fresh water, mainly on the stagnant water. Stagnant water means standing water, standing water. So next, cell wall is absent. Cell wall is absent. Cell wall is absent in this one. So instead of cell wall, protein layer is present. This protein layer is known as the pellicle. Due to the presence of pellicle, the body become flexible. Okay, so that is known as a pellicle. It is that objective bit, the body become flexible, right? So at the anterior side, so this euglena is invaginate. Invaginate means folding like structures. This folding like structures having that cytostome. Cytostome means it is known as a gullet. Cytostome means it is that cell mouth. Cytostome means it is known as that cell mouth. After then, cytopharynx. Gullet. So reservoir, on that membrane, okay, it means a photosensitive spot is present. So this is known as the reservoir. Okay, this is known as that cytostome. After that, this is known as that cytopharynx. So these are reserve on the membrane of the reservoir. Okay, it means eye spot is present. This is known as the eye spot. Okay, it is able to absorbing light. Okay, due to the presence of pigment, it is known as photosynthetic light absorbing pigment. Light absorbing pigment. So that is known as that eye spot. Okay, that is known as that euglena. So after that, euglena generally it means asexual reproduction takes place by that longitudinal binary fission. Longitudinal binary fission, right? So generally it means it is act as plant and animals. Due to the presence of eye spot, okay, it is absorbing light, performing the photosynthesis. In absence of light, it is act as a predators on small organism. Okay, so it means they are known as a heterotrophic condition. It's showing both. Okay, So due to the presence of light absorbing pigment eye spot and paramyelin starch, storage of food in the form of starch, okay, they are known as that plant characters, absent of cell wall, okay, and it is act as a predators. So these are that animal characters, and it's showing of that palmella, it means the palmella stage. Palmella stage. So what is the meaning of the palmella stage? Palmella stage means, for example, at the time of unfavorable condition, euglena loss of their flagella. Euglenas loss of their flagella and present at rest condition. So by the producing of mucilage layer around of its own, so that is known as that palmella stage. Resting period by the formation of mucilage layer, okay, around of its own, so they are known as that, okay, palmella stage. Palmella stage means in euglena at the time of unfavorable condition, loss of their flagella, loss of that flagella, okay, so they are present, they're producing of a mucilage layer around of its own, present at rest condition, so that is known as palmella stage. Generally this is palmella stage is present in some green algae, so that is known as that chlamydomonas. It is similar to that stage of chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas are also showing of that palmella stage, so that is known as that euglena. Euglena. After that euglena, what is that? Slime molds. So these are the slime molds are generally saprophytic protists. Saprophytic protists are known as the slime molds. Okay, so it is known as that multinucleated mass of protoplasm. Multinucleated mass of protoplasm surrounded by that plasma membrane. Okay, multinucleated mass of protoplasm surrounded by surrounded by cell membrane. So that is known as that plasmodium. Okay, so it means it grows several, it grows on that, is generally is a saprophytic condition. It is a saprophytic. So in the saprophytic, so it grows on decaying twig. Decaying twig and so leaves, okay, absorbing organic material from the dead substrates. So absorbing organic material from dead substrates like the decaying twig and leaves. So that is known as a saprophytic condition. At the time of unfavorable condition, they're producing of the plasmodium. This multinucleated mass of protoplasm is surrounded by the cell membrane. Okay, so it means it absorbing from that decaying of twig and leaves, it producing several fruits grows in like in that feet. Okay, after that, so in the plasmodium, it producing of the fruiting bodies. Cytoplasm is producing fruiting bodies at unfavorable condition. So this fruiting body is producing of the spores. This spores having that true walls. It is the objective bit. True walls. So due to the presence of true walls, so these spores can germinate. Okay. So at that unfavorable, at that favorable condition getting, these spores are germinate producing of that. Okay. So new slime molds. Due to the presence of true walls, they are resistant to that. Okay, so drought conditions, They are known as that slime mouths, right?